Is December 25th the real birthday of Jesus? Christ is born. Although most Christians celebrate December 25th as the birthday of Jesus Christ, few in the first two Christian centuries claimed any knowledge of the exact day or year in which he was born. The oldest existing record of a Christmas celebration is found in a Roman almanac that tells of a Christ's Nativity festival led by the Church of Rome in 336 AD. The precise reason why Christmas came to be celebrated on December 25th remains obscure, but most researchers believe that Christmas originated as a Christian substitute for pagan celebrations of the winter solstice. To early Christians and to many Christians today, the most important holiday on the Christian calendar was Easter, which commemorates the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ. However, as Christianity began to take hold in the Roman world, in the early 4th century, church leaders had to contend with the popular Roman pagan holiday commemorating the birthday of the unconquered sun natalis solis invicti, the Roman name for the winter solstice. Every winter, Romans honored the pagan god Saturn, the god of agriculture, with a festival that began on December 17th and usually ended on or around December 25th with a winter solstice celebration in honor of the beginning of the new solar cycle. This festival was a time of merrymaking, and families and friends would exchange gifts. At the same time, Mithraism worship of the ancient Persian god of light was popular in the Roman army, and the cult held some of its most important rituals on the winter solstice. After the Roman Emperor Constantine I converted to Christianity in 312 and sanctioned Christianity, church leaders made efforts to appropriate the winter solstice holidays and thereby achieve a more seamless conversion to Christianity for the emperor's subjects. In rationalizing the celebration of Jesus' birthday in late December, church leaders may have argued that since the world was allegedly created on the spring equinox late March, so too would Jesus have been conceived by God on that date. The Virgin Mary, pregnant with the Son of God, would hence have given birth to Jesus 9 months later on the winter solstice. From Rome, the Christ's Nativity celebration spread to other Christian churches to the west and east, and soon most Christians were celebrating Christ's birth on December 25th. To the Roman celebration was later added other winter solstice rituals observed by various pagan groups, such as the lighting of the Yule log and decorations with evergreens by Germanic tribes. The word Christmas entered the English language originally as Christ's Mass, meaning Christ's Mass or Festival of Christ in Old English. A popular medieval feast was that of Saint Nicholas of Myra, a saint said to visit children with gifts and admonitions just before Christmas. This story evolved into the modern practice of leaving gifts for children said to be brought by Santa Claus, a derivative of the Dutch name for Saint Nicholas Sinterklaas. Thank you for watching. For the follow-up, subscribe to the channel yourself here. Christmas Day in the United States. Many people in the United States celebrate Christmas Day on December 25th. The day celebrates Jesus Christ's birth. It is often combined with customs from pre-Christian winter celebrations. Many people erect Christmas trees, decorate their homes, visit family or friends and exchange gifts. What do people do? People celebrate Christmas Day in many ways. In the days or even weeks before Christmas Day, many people decorate their homes and gardens with lights, Christmas trees and much more. It is common to organize a special meal, often consisting of turkey and a lot of other festive foods, for family or friends and exchange gifts with them. Children, in particular, often receive a lot of gifts from their parents and other relatives and the mythical figure Santa Claus. This has led to Christmas Day becoming an increasingly commercialized holiday, with a lot of families spending a large part of their income on gifts and food. Many Sunday schools, churches and communities organize special events. These can include decorating the neighborhood or a shopping mall, putting up a Christmas tree and planning a nativity display, concert or performance. A lot of plays and songs have aspect of Christmas as a theme. Some groups arrange meals, shelter or charitable projects for people without a home or with very little money. Public life. Government offices, organizations, businesses and schools are closed, almost without exception. Many people visit relatives or friends and are out of town. This may cause congestion on highways and at airports. Public transit systems do not run on their regular schedules. In general, public life closes down completely. Background. The original meaning of Christmas is a special church service, or mass, to celebrate the birth of Christ. The story of the Nativity, or the events surrounding the birth of Jesus, are particularly important in religious celebrations of Christmas. However, many traditions that are around today have their roots in pre-Christian winter festivals. These include the importance of candles and decorations made from evergreen bushes and tree, symbolizing everlasting light and life. In Roman times, a midwinter festival was held. This was a relaxing time with a lot of parties and merrymaking. It was also common to give other people small gifts, such as dolls for children and candles for adults. This festival culminated with the celebration of the winter solstice, which fell on December 25th in the Roman calendar. In Scandinavia, a festival called Yule and lasting up to 12 days was held in late December and early January. In this time people burnt logs and held parties. These customs have influences how Christmas Day is celebrated today in the United States. The Bible does not give a precise date for the birth of Jesus. It is also unclear when December 25th became associated with the birth of Jesus, although it may have been around 200 years after his birth. In the early centuries of Christianity, the anniversary of the birth of Jesus was not a cause for celebrations. The idea of turning this day into a celebration started in the early Middle Ages in Europe. During Reformation and up until the middle of the 1800s, Christmas was often not celebrated because partying and merrymaking was seen as unchristian. From about 1840, celebrating Christmas became more widespread. December 25th was declared a federal holiday in the United States in 1870. Since then, Christmas Day has become a steadily more important holiday. Symbols. A wide range of people and objects represent Christmas. These include baby Jesus, the Nativity and the Three Kings, but also Santa Claus, reindeer and elves. Common objects at this time of year are pine trees, holly, decorations, fairy lights, candles and presents. Christmas Day is now truly a mix of religious celebration and commercial interests. Thank you for watching. For the follow-up, subscribe to the channel yourself here. What is the meaning of Noel? Every year, people sing songs like the first Noel at Christmas, and many wonder what a Noel is. In French, Joyeux Noël means Merry Christmas. Our modern English word comes from the Middle English Noël, which Webster's 1828 dictionary defined as a shout of joy or Christmas song. The roots of the word are the French Noël Christmas season, which may come from the old French Noël. This, in turn, is derived from the Latin natalis, meaning birth. Since Christmas is the celebration of the birth of Christ, it was natural for people to refer to the celebration as the Nativity or the birth. Another possible root for Noël, also from the French, is the word nouvelles, meaning news. As the popular carol says, the first Noël the angels did say/was to certain poor shepherds. The meaning of news certainly makes sense in that context. However, the early usage and definition of Noël seem to focus more on the idea of birth, and that is probably the more accurate meaning. There are very few records giving the details of the earliest Christmas practices, but at least as early as the 4th century, some Christian groups were celebrating Natus Christus on December 25th. Since their almanac referred to the day as the birth of Christ, it would be natural to see derivative words like Nail and Noel used in the same way. In the Middle Ages, several English carols began with Noel, and French carols similarly used Noel. Since early songs often used the first word as the title, a Noel came to refer to any song about the birth of Christ. Because of this, the word now carries the dual meaning of a Christmas song and the Christmas celebration itself. Our English carol The First Noel was first published in a book titled Carols Ancient and Modern, edited by William Sandys in 1823. The message of the song is the joyous pronouncement that the King of Israel has been born. When we sing the song or wish someone a joyous Noel, we are following the example of the angels, announcing the good news that Jesus Christ was born, not just for Israel, but for all mankind, so we could receive forgiveness of sins through Him. Thank you for watching. For the follow-up, subscribe to the channel yourself here.